Welcome back to Ever Sin Boyfriend. This is Ida.
And I'm Chancellor. Happy New Year's, guys. 2022.
Happy New Year's, everyone. Today we have another video. So you may have seen our video that we filmed yesterday about Tabit by Tiziana Terenzi. We brought up a couple of topics in that video that we kind of want to discuss further today. Please stay tuned.
Stay tuned, guys.
Chancellor brought up some really good points yesterday when he smelled Tiziana Terenzi's Tabit for the first time. And I brought up some points in regards to how we both perceive that fragrance. So it made us kind of think more about, you know, what notes, what different components of a fragrance kind of make a masculine versus a feminine fragrance for us.
She was asking me certain questions. Okay, well, what makes this smell masculine? What makes this more feminine? As I got to thinking about it more and more, and I was kind of describing floral notes, powdery, the dry down, I said it was more woody. I got more of the oak, the musk. It smelled more like a oud to me. Mm-hmm. And then I was also explaining, okay, during that, I associated that with masculine, more of a masculine scent versus a feminine scent. Why did I do that? Because I think there's like a neuroscience component. I read an article this morning, and it asked a question, okay, well, are all fragrances genderless? And technically, yes, they are. Feminine versus masculine, there was a debate going on. But as I read more into the article, it pointed out some things that I kind of instinctually kind of thought of myself. So as a man, I grew up with like my grandfather and my father, they would wear different fragrances, even different deodorants. Why? Because, you know, my grandfather, he would work. He was a contractor. He would work in construction. According to this article, dating back to European 19th century, there were certain societal roles that men had, like white collar men that would work in the city. They would toil and they would do certain things like throughout the day. And we know that the anatomy of a male is different from that of a female. So these men that would work in the cities, they would be known to have more earthy, musky, right. Woody.
So if you're working, naturally you'll perspire more. You may have a body odor. Not necessarily saying that you may smell horrible, or you smell bad or something like that, but naturally you're, what you naturally smell like comes out more. So you may have a scent that matches more what you smell like. In that way, you mean?
Absolutely, absolutely. So those gentlemen that was working in the 19th century, and you know, they were again associated with the woody, musky florals. And when she was asking me those questions yesterday, naturally my mind went to, okay, my grandfather, during the dry down, that reminded me of my grandfather, some of the fragrances he was wearing as he would be getting ready for church and getting me ready. I would smell that coming off of him. And he was doing something masculine, like tying a tie, teaching me how to tie a tie. So I think the neuroscience of that kind of automatically connected with me.
And not only that too, but you also can associate a scent with how a gender behaves, right? Now, you say how a gender behaves. The only way we kind of know that or pick up on those kind of things is that small children, our parents, our grandparents may do certain things for us, right? And you just notice the fashion in which they do it. It may not be particular to you know, you may associate certain things with gender. For example, what I can think of is when your parents are putting lotion on your face. You know what I mean? The difference of my father putting lotion on my face versus my mother putting lotion on my face. She may be a bit more delicate. She may be a bit more, you know, kind of smoothing out your eyebrows and your cheeks and things like that. And then you can also like smell how sweet she smells naturally when she's doing this. You know what I mean? So you associate that with femininity. So I think naturally more feminine fragrances to you might be something that smells soft and light like your mom. Almost like you're looking for a scent that associates with those actions. Whereas your father, it's not saying that he's rough, but he has more strength. He may smooth out the lotion and kind of go in your face and dang near take your whole face off in a loving way. But at the same time, you're smelling the woodiness, maybe his natural essence, and he smells a little bit different from your mom, you know? And I would say these interactions are natural to us as humans. You know, you may notice different things like genders. Now, we also kind of talked about how men smell different naturally, whereas a feminine fragrance, technically, what we consider feminine notes, maybe. When you put them on a masculine, on a man, his essence may change that, and you may smell a sharper, more woody scent versus the really floral. So, like, what are you talking about, like, women's skin?
Women, based on studies, women's skin tends to be more acidic. So what that means is, you know, like something that I may spray on myself that may come across as masculine during dry down, spray that on Saida, it becomes more feminine based on like her skin alchemy.
You know, it's up for debate, but technically, the genders are different, and we have different things going on with our skins, different things with our body odor, different things with our hormones. We have to be mindful of that too, and that can also alter or change fragrances. That's why it's very important to test fragrance on your skin, because our natural body chemistry can change your fragrance.
Me personally, I'm just gonna say this, I'll make this note. I'll take it away from you, I'll put it on me. Mm-hmm. So, when she was asking me those questions yesterday about, okay, well, what makes this more of a feminine scent versus masculine and vice versa, again, in society, when we're out and just living, we associate different things with different people. So for example, working at an office, maybe you're working at a cubicle and there's like a very feminine woman who wears dresses, she's very elegant, things like this. If you somehow smelled her and she came in wearing like a men's fragrance and she had like a male scent on, or Right Guard or Degree or Old Spice or something like that, wouldn't that kind of confuse you as a man? Like, because what you see on the outside doesn't match what you're smelling from her. It's a contradiction. So it's kind of confusing. So when she was asking me that question yesterday during the dry down, I'm like, oh, okay, I can see how it's still an intimate fragrance and it still works for certain women, but for me, it doesn't set with me because the dry down smells too oody, too woody, too musky.
People would say things like men smell like oud, women smell like flowers and fruits. You know, so I would say, some people say, okay, that's stereotypical, you know what I mean? But maybe there's some truth to it. There's a lot of truth to stereotypes, you know, or some truth. I'm gonna say a lot of truth. So maybe these things, but you know what? Wear whatever you like, you know, definitely enjoy it, whatever you like. But you know, obviously there are some things that we decide versus the marketing that companies give us that we decide are feminine and masculine. Some things you'd rather smell like. Like for me, I'm not big into unisex fragrances. I like really, really what I decide is feminine. So you said you decide that feminine fragrances are what?
Typically fruity. Now that could be the unisex too, but fruity, powdery, and floral for the most part, because I associate powders with, okay, my grandma putting powder on, going off her church. I'm associating florals for, you know, what I seen in the article earlier, as women back in those times, you know, maybe not gardening, but they're working with flowers within their home.
Gardening or...
Right. Vanilla as a woman baking. You see what I mean?
Working in the kitchen. And men's fragrances, you tend to be a little sharper and deeper. And you know, and we even think about men's roles in society, right? The leadership and the different things that men do, right? Maybe a lot of fragrances that men wear command a lot of attention and power. And this is why we call like beast mode fragrances, like Tabit, right? In that dry down, we say, oh yeah, I'm commanding attention. Maybe subconsciously we're thinking that I command attention because there's a masculine element to this and men command that attention, maybe. I can see that. So as a man, like, what is the importance of smelling, you know, certain types of scents on women? Like if it just hits you by accident or just in a crowd, like what does that do for you as a man?
It associates what I'm seeing visually to what I'm smelling. Mm-hmm. You know, it's connecting two senses together. So kind of like in the example I was explaining, it would be confusing as a man to like see a woman that's really elegant, her hair is done, you know, everything is prim proper, but then to smell something kind of oody or musky, anything beast mode. Because again, she's so light and she's so elegant. This is what we're thinking as men. But then to juxtapose that against a musky, more beast mode sort of scent, it's kind of like, ooh, okay.
Maybe women have a frailer or more gentle, you know, our bodies are smaller than men usually. Our arms and our wrists are usually smaller. So that fragile nature, you want to almost like attach that to something light and fluffy and airy, kind of associates with that versus like a really heavy, deep tobacco or some kind of scent like that. You're saying, okay, so I can understand that. So, you know, we're kind of talking about senses here. You're using your sight and your sense of smell to kind of tie things together, and it makes sense subconsciously, you know. But like we said, feel free to wear whatever you would like. If you enjoy it, if you know, if it makes you happy, that's the most important thing. We're just kind of talking about our take on how we perceive fragrances with gender, and we hope you enjoyed. Come back and have a scent boyfriend. Please like and subscribe, comment. I love your comments, and I hope you have a happy new year.
Bye, guys. I'll see you next time.
Bye.